Hello. Today we are going to make a couple heads. We will work in similar way as we did in previously published instruction, cake and umbrella. Inflate all balloons leaving about 1 inch flat tail. In this example, I use 6 balloons of rainbow colors. Twist the first yellow about 5 inch bubble. Lock the free end of the first yellow bubble with the nozzle of the orange balloon. Twist the first 5 inch orange bubble. Lock the free end of the first orange bubble with the nozzle of the red balloon. Keep working in this fashion to make the first row of 6 rainbow bubbles. In the same row, we twist all bubbles of the same size. To make smaller size heads, we twist smaller size bubbles, and for larger size heads, we twist larger size bubbles. Working in this fashion, we can actually use less or more balloons. Once again, in this example, I use 6 balloons, rainbow colors. Let's get back to our sculpture. Twist the first blue bubble. Lock the free end of the first blue bubble with the nozzle of the purple balloon. Twist the first about 5 inch purple bubble. Lock the free end of the first purple bubble with the nozzle of the yellow balloon. We have made the first row of the head. I'm going to work the second row in the same direction. Twist the second about 1 inch purple bubble. Twist the third about 5 inch purple bubble. Twist the second yellow about 1 inch bubble. Lock the free end of the second yellow bubble with the free end of the third purple bubble. Twist the third yellow about 5 inch bubble. Twist the second orange about 1 inch bubble. Lock the free end of the second orange bubble with the free end of the third yellow bubble. Keep working in the same fashion to make the second row. In this example, I work the second row in the same direction as we did the first row. This way, we make kind of a zigzag color pattern. If we work the second row in opposite direction, we would have different color pattern. You can find some examples of different color patterns in previously published instruction Fabric 8 Surfboard. You can use one color balloons to make a flower head. Okay, here we came to the last bubble of the second row. Twist the third about 5 inch blue bubble. Lock the free end of the third blue bubble between the second and the third purple bubbles. Okay, we have made the second row. Also, we have made the head. Well, it is a simplified version of the head that we are working on. We can use it as it is. That's a bottom view. And here's a side view. From here, we can proceed in different ways to make different shape heads. We can use the rest of the balloons to add more rows. We can lock both ends of each balloon in one lock twist. We can work the rest of the balloons in opposite direction, lock both ends of each balloon in one lock twist to make petals of flower. So let's make it. Lock both ends of the blue balloon in one lock twist. We can fix the fourth bubbles in different ways. For example, we can put each following petal on top of previous one, or we can interlace the petals. In this example, I'm going to interlace fourth bubbles. So we force the green balloon through the loop of the fourth blue bubble and lock both ends of the green balloon in one lock twist. Next, we force the red balloon through the loop of the fourth green bubble and lock both ends of the red balloon in one lock twist. Force the orange balloon through the loop of the fourth red bubble and lock both ends of the orange balloon in one lock twist. Work the rest of the head in the same fashion. For my convenience, I hold the sculpture from the bottom and I keep all ends of balloons on top of the head. Work all balloons of the same row in the same direction. And here we're making the sixth petal. For the purple balloon through the loop of the yellow balloon, bring it on top of the sculpture and force it through the loop of the blue fourth bubble. Lock both ends of the purple balloon in one lock twist. Congratulations, we have made the rainbow hat or flower hat. All petals interlaced in the same way. Here's a side view and here's a top view. The top view and the bottom view actually the same. Well, almost the same. Once again, we can use just one color or different color balloons to make different color patterns. It is a large size hat. Adults or kids, anyone wearing this hat looks really good. In the following example, we're going to use six balloons again. Three colors, white, blue, and red. Three colors of national flag, well, national flags. Alright, so in this example I put the colors in following order. White, blue, red, and then we do it again. White, blue, red. Again, you can place the colors in whatever order you like. I'm going to first play this part of the video clip. I'm going to work the second row of the hat in the same direction as we did the first row. If you want, you can work the second row in opposite direction. It's up to you. And once again, it's all up to you how many rows you're gonna make for the hat. You can start with one and add as many rows as you want. It's all up to you. Okay, in this example, we have made so far two rows. And now we're going to make, let's make the same flower hat as we did rainbow hat. But this time we use three colors instead of six. So it's gonna be different color pattern. There are many differences we can make. We can lock the end of the balloon between the second and third bubbles of the same colors. Let's twist about 1 inch bubble at end of each balloon. And we're going to use this 1 inch bubble bubbles to lock both ends of each balloon in one lock twist. And again, to avoid any confusion with balloons, I hold the sculpture from the bottom and I keep all balloons, ends of the balloons on top of the sculpture. And again, in the same row, we work all balloons in the same direction. Instead of twisting 1 inch bubbles at end of the balloon, as we do it in this example, we can twist bigger bubbles or larger sized bubbles and use it to make different hats or variations of crown. So actually we can say that it is a basic hat that we can use to make variations of hats and to make many different sculptures. Ways, baskets, and so on. Let's get back to our sculpture. We're almost done here. Working on the last petal for the red balloon through the loop of the white fourth bubble, bring it on top of the head and then force it through the loop of the fourth blue bubble, like both ends of the red balloon in one lock twist. Congratulations again, we have made the hat or three colors flower. Here's a bottom view, side view, and the top view. I want to use this hat in the next example, so I'm going to untwist last bubbles of each balloon. So now we're going to start from the point where we have already made two first rows. In previous examples, we use the rest of the balloon to make the petals, simply by locking both ends of each balloon in one lock twist. In the following example, we're going to do basically the same thing. With only one difference, we're going to work the fourth bubbles in the same direction as we work the second and the first row. Loop the rest of the red balloon around the head, working in the same direction as we did the second row, twist 1 inch bubble at the end of the balloon and lock both ends of the red balloon in one lock twist. Loop the blue balloon around the head. Twist 1-inch bubble at the end of the balloon. Lock both ends of the blue balloon in one lock twist. Work the rest of the sculpture in the same fashion. As you already know, I keep all working balloons on top of the sculpture, and I work the sculpture by holding it from the bottom. In this example, I place each following balloon on top of the previous balloon, if you look from the bottom view. And I do not interlace force bubbles at all. We work on quite simple color pattern. Nevertheless, be careful. With all its simplicity, you may get really easy confused when you work on this sculpture. Just keep in mind those simple rules. All balloons of one row will work in the same direction. Also, I think it's very helpful to hold the sculpture on one side when you work on one row. I prefer to hold the sculpture from the bottom view. At the same time, we keep all working balloons on the top of the sculpture. In our example, we're getting closer to the end. Congratulations, we have made the head. Here's the top view. And this is a side view. This is the bottom view. And again, we can fix the bubbles on top of the head in different positions. Okay, now I'm going to put the head on so you can see how it looks like. We have made a couple heads today. Let's put them next to each other to see the difference. And again, we can use the same technique to make many different sculptures. Have fun and happy twisting!